Welcome to Shopkeep Video Support. I'm Rob, here to help you learn how to add modifiers to inventory items and ring them up at the register. Let's get started. Modifiers are item options that make customizing orders easier. They can be used to specify an item's size, add extra toppings, hold ingredients, and more. Let's add some modifiers to an item. In Back Office, click Items, then Item List. Items with variants do not support modifiers, so either select an existing basic item to edit, or click Add New to set up a new one. If setting up a new item, click Create under Basic Item. On the New Item form, enter the item's details, and click Save. Now, from the Edit page, click the Modifiers tab. To prevent the register from automatically prompting cashiers to select modifiers for this item, uncheck Show Modifiers when I sell this item. Now, we'll add some single choice modifiers. These allow a customer to make one selection from a group of multiple options, such as when choosing the type of cheese for a burger. To add a group of single choice modifiers, click Add a Group. Enter a name for the group, then enter the base or default option. Click Add another option, and fill in a second choice. Continue adding options to the group as needed. To change which option is the base, check the gray box next to an option. If an option requires an extra charge, enter that amount in the Add to Price field. Click and drag the arrows next to an option to change the order in which it appears on the register. To create an additional group of single choice modifiers, click Add another group, then follow the same steps to set it up. Next, let's add some multiple choice modifiers. Customers can select as many of these as they want, but no more than one of each. There are two types of multiple choice modifiers, add-ons and no options. Add-ons are used for toppings and other extras a customer can add. To create an add-on, click Add an option under Add-ons, enter a name, and fill in the Add to Price field if necessary. Click Add another option if you need to enter more add-ons. No options are used to hold ingredients that normally come standard with an item. To create a no option, click Add an option under No Options, and enter a name. To charge less when a no option is used, enter an amount to subtract from the item's price under Discount when off. Click Add another option to enter more no options. After setting up all of the item's modifiers, click OK to save. Then, go to the register and tap Get Updates on the control panel to sync the new modifiers from Back Office. Now, let's copy the modifiers we just set up to another item that needs the same modifiers. From the Back Office item list, add a new basic item or select an existing basic item to copy modifiers to. Then, click the Modifiers tab. To copy over a group of single choice modifiers, click the drop-down in the single choice area. Search for an item, and select a group to copy. If you need to copy additional groups, just repeat these steps. To copy over all of an item's multiple choice modifiers, click the drop-down in the multiple choice area. Search for an item and click to select it. Click OK to save, then get updates on the register to sync the changes. While we're at the register, let's ring up an item with modifiers. First, add an item to a sale. Depending on your settings, the item's modifiers may or may not appear automatically. If they appear, tap to select or deselect modifiers, then Done to confirm. If modifiers do not appear, tap the line item to open the modifiers prompt. Then make your selections and tap Done. When you're ready, finish processing the transaction as usual. Modifiers will print on kitchen tickets for applicable items and also on receipts. That's all there is to it. If you have any questions, just visit us online at shopkeep.com/support.